Just like in people, the eye of a dog is a very delicate structure that can easily be affected by a huge number of different conditions. If your dog's eye seems swollen, red, and inflamed, he may be suffering from conjunctivitis, aka pink eye. Watch this video as I'll be explaining exactly what conjunctivitis in dogs is, as well as what the causes, clinical signs, diagnosis, treatment, and prevention methods are, so that you can be better equipped to understand what might be going on and how you can help him. Hey guys, Dogtor. I am a veterinarian from South Africa. Now, conjunctivitis refers to a condition in which the pink tissue inside the eyelid, which is called the conjunctiva, becomes inflamed. Now, the conjunctiva is a type of mucous membrane that covers the eyeball and lines the inner eyelids. It contains a layer of epithelial cells that secretes mucus, and its main function is basically to protect the eyeball from the environment by acting as a protective layer. Now, in a healthy dog, the conjunctiva of the eyelids is not really visible and has a pale pinkish color. Now, when conjunctivitis occurs, the conjunctival membrane becomes very red and very swollen. Now, signs that you will probably notice with conjunctivitis include a squinting or spasmodic blinking, also known as blepharospasm, redness and swelling of the moist tissue of the eye, which makes the eyes look kind of puffy. The dog may paw at the eye or pinch it closed. The white part of the eye, or sclera, will be red and inflamed. And you may also see a discharge coming from the eyes, which may either be clear or even contain mucus or pus, which will appear kind of like a cloudy yellow or greenish color. Now, conjunctivitis may include either just the one eye or both. It can also occur with other clinical signs, such as a nasal discharge, sneezing, and even coughing. Now, breeds that tend to have underlying allergies or autoimmune skin diseases tend to be more prone to developing this inflammation of the conjunctiva, and brachycephalic breeds, such as pugs, are also more at risk as their eyeballs are much more exposed and more likely to get injured. Now, there are many potential causes for conjunctivitis in dogs, and these can basically be broadly classified as bacterial infections, mostly secondary to other conditions such as dry eye, viral infections such as canine distemper virus, immune-mediated conditions such as allergies, autoimmune diseases, and cancers, tear film deficiency such as KCS or dry eye, eyelid abnormalities such as ectropion and entropion, eyelash disorders such as dystichiasis or ectopic cilia, an obstructed tear duct. It could also be secondary to trauma or environmental causes such as a foreign body in the moist tissue of the eye, or irritation from pollen, dust, smoke and chemicals, or even eye medication. And finally, it could also be secondary to other eye conditions such as ulcerative keratitis, anterior uveitis, or glaucoma. Now, as with any condition, your vet will first start off with getting a full history as to when the dog started showing clinical signs, how long it has been going on for, and if it has gotten progressively worse or not. You will then conduct a full clinical exam to try and identify other underlying systemic conditions such as a skin allergy. Now, the main goal of diagnosis is to try and determine if the conjunctivitis is either a primary or secondary problem, if there's any additional diseases or damage to the eye, if the condition is allergic, or if it involves the tissue of the eye itself, such as the sclera. Now, in order to differentiate many of these conditions, your vet may need to perform a complete and detailed ophthalmic examination. This will include a detailed examination of the surrounding eye structures, such as the eyelids and eyelashes, tear ducts, and third eyelid, a Schirmer tear test to evaluate the eyeball's ability to produce enough tears, a corneal stain test, such as a fluorescent stain test, to ensure that the cornea is not damaged, and the measurement of the intraocular pressure to rule out glaucoma or uveitis. Now, more advanced tests and procedures that may be recommended may also include a nasolacrimal duct flushing, bacterial culture of the eye discharge, conjunctival cytology, and allergy testing. Now, as you can see, there are many possible causes for conjunctivitis in dogs, and the treatment will therefore depend on the exact underlying problem and may include both topical and oral medications. If there is a foreign body present in the eye, then your vet may attempt to remove it under either local or general anesthesia, using saline to wash it out, or ophthalmic equipment to physically remove it from the eyeball. If it is a bacterial infection, then your vet will prescribe a topical antibiotic ointment such as Exosyn or Chloramix, which needs to be applied to the infected eye around about 1 to 4 times a day. If there is inflammation present but no ulcer could be detected, then your vet may prescribe topical steroids that needs to be administered to the eyeball. If the dog is suffering from KCS or dry eye, then your vet may prescribe tacrolimus or cyclosporin, which helps to improve the tear production in the tear glands, as well as artificial tears to keep the eyeball lubricated. And if the infection is very severe, there's an aggressive cancer, or the cornea is ruptured, then specialized surgery will be necessary to try and save the eye. Or the eye can also be completely removed to prevent further pain and discomfort. If your dog is suffering from an underlying skin allergy, then your vet will need to address the allergy first. And if you want more info on skin allergies in dogs, then make sure to check my video over here. If your dog is constantly scratching at the eye and causing further damage, then he might need to get an Elizabethan collar to help protect his eyes from his self-inflicted harm. He may feel a bit embarrassed wearing this, but it will definitely help speed up the recovery process. Now, in addition to the medication that your vet will prescribe, there are also a couple of other things that you can try at home to help clear up the condition a bit faster. First, clean out the eyes with a specific eye wash or saline and wipe the sides of the eyelids using lukewarm water and a cotton ball to try and get rid of the impacted discharge. This is often a breeding ground for other bacteria, so make sure that you clean out the eyes properly before administering any eye ointments. For eye drops, tilt your dog's head back a little, then resting your hand on the dog's head so you don't hit its eye with the dropper if the dog moves, squeeze drops into the upper part of the dog's eye. To apply ointment, gently pull down your dog's lower eyelid to create a small pocket for the ointment, and while resting your hand on his head, squeeze a ribbon of ointment into the dog's eye. After this, gently open and close his eyelids for a few seconds to help spread the ointment or drops evenly. If you need to apply more than one ointment or solution, then wait at least 5 to 10 minutes before applying each, as you need to allow it some time to be properly absorbed. To help keep your furry friend's eyes bright and healthy, keep long hair out of its eyes by taking your dog to a groomer, or by trimming the hair yourself, and keep irritants such as shampoos, soaps, and flea medicine away from his eyes. If the eyes are very swollen, then you can also try a cold compress, which is basically a cold wet washcloth that you gently press over the closed eye for a couple of minutes every single day. This will help reduce the swelling and relieve some of the pain and discomfort that your pet is experiencing. Now, if the condition worsens and your pet is not really responding well to the treatment, then take your dog back for a follow-up so that your vet can adjust the treatment protocol. Now, it is really important that you do not try and treat an undiagnosed eye condition yourself, as medication for one condition may aggravate another condition and in the end cause much more damage to the eye. Now, depending on what the exact cause may be, conjunctivitis may very well be contagious. So, to decrease the risk of spreading a potential infectious disease such as distemper, try not to expose your dog to other pets and wash your hands thoroughly with soap and water after handling him in order to prevent the infection from spreading to other animals. Now, I know that all of this sounds quite overwhelming and excessive, but it is not always easy to pinpoint directly at the exact cause of the eye problem. Your vet will need to follow a very systematic approach, and this is really important, as if conjunctivitis is left for too long, the eyeball can get severely damaged, which can ultimately lead to blindness or even the loss of an eye when left untreated. Most dogs have an excellent prognosis in most cases of conjunctivitis, And it really depends on how extensive the damage is and how quickly treatment was started. If the conjunctivitis is secondary to an underlying disease, such as KCS or immune-mediated disorders, then your dog may require lifelong therapy to keep him comfortable, in which case they will still enjoy a good quality of life. It is important to remember that the quicker it is treated, the more successful the treatment is likely to be. Now, if you notice any pain, discharge, or redness in your pet's eye, then it is really important to take him to the vet for an assessment. Thank you for watching this video, guys. If you found this video to be helpful, I would really appreciate it if you can leave a like on this video and share it with your friends and your family. Now, if you are not yet convinced that your dog is suffering from conjunctivitis, then make sure to check out my playlist over here on the top 10 most common eye problems in dogs so that you might get a better idea of what your dog is dealing with. And if you are new to my channel, consider subscribing as I'll be posting new videos on interesting pet-related topics every week. As always, guys, have a lucky day, and I'll see you in another video next week. Cheers!